for today's message, I would like us to focus on verses 37 through 40.
All right.
It reads, "Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when did we see you home and feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you a stranger and invite you in, or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison and go to visit you?" The king will reply, "Truly, I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did it for me."
So when you mix those goat and sheep,
all in one flock. The sheep, they kind of follow the lead of goats, mm-hmm. and they keep moving too. So by doing this, this prevents overgrazing. So it preserves the health of the pastures that are vital to both of the animals. So the reason I share this with you is that to make sure you're aware that goats are not all bad. There are other places in the Bible where goats are used as a positive metaphor symbol. It just so happens that in this text, the goats are used to illustrate the fate of the lost. Wow. And speaking about the end times.
Great.
So now we're told at the start of our passage today, when the Son of Man comes in his glory, the people will be gathered to him. Jesus describes this gathered group as a mixed flock, contains both sheep and goats. Mm-hmm. And these sheep and goats, they're just simply mixed up together in the church. Oh, I'm sorry.
My sisters and brothers, what Jesus is talking about
is love.
Amen.
The righteous demonstrated the love of Christ.
Well.
The morally right were astonished that in caring for the needs of those who suffered, they were actually ministering to the Lord himself. They proclaimed to be Christians, so without even thinking, their actions demonstrated Christ's love. Love is not something you just talk about. Now, don't get me wrong, it is wonderful to tell people that you love them. But in addition, it's Christ-like to express that love in more tangible ways. Jesus said to feed the needy, give drink to the thirsty, clothe the naked, welcome the stranger, visit the sick and the prison, and do these things with a heart of love. Some of you may have heard recently on the news that a homeless man helped a woman get some gas in her car. She got stranded right there on New Jersey Freeway. He gave her his last $20 to go get some gas. And not only that, now she was stranded on the side of the road at night, in the middle of the highway. He was off on the side of the road, so happens. I wonder how that happens. So God sitting there, told her, get back in your car. Don't you go walking anywhere this time of night. It's dangerous out here. You get back in your car and lock the doors. He went and got the gas for her.
All right.
Spent his last $20 and got the gas for her. That's what I call giving sacrificially.
All right.
He gave to her without even thinking about what he might get back. Now I want to tell you, I want to share with you. It turned out that he actually gave her a lot more than $20. Because she went to find him, paying back. And ended up talking to this homeless man, getting to know him. She got into a relationship with him. She heard his story. He inspired her so much that she set up a GoFundMe page for him. The goal was $10,000. And if you heard what he's up to him? Over $300,000. She, in essence, provided him with the ability to get food, clothing, and shelter for years to come. And all he wants to do is to find a job. He had one before. I think he's a helicopter pilot or something like that. And he's a veteran. And once he finds a job, he just wants to share the money that she raised for him to others that also are in need of help. So he showed love to someone else, and in return, God blessed him with so much more. And what the righteous have in common is why they had to ask the question.
Well,
what you talking about, Jesus? The righteous give the love of Christ to others with humility. Jesus encouraged humility as his mission was unconditional compassion for the bad and the destitute in society. Earlier in the Gospel of Matthew, Jesus promised the righteous would be rewarded with the keys to the kingdom of heaven. There's also a very famous saint that demonstrated almost as well as Jesus what it's like to be humble. Someone whose life I really admire, Mother Teresa, a Roman Catholic nun from Yugoslavia who moved to Calcutta, India. She started a religious community called the Missionaries of Charity. It was to represent the poor of the world, the unwanted, the unloved, the uncared, the crippled, the blind, the lepers, the alcoholics, the people thrown away by society, people who have forgotten what human love is, or the human touch. Now, Mother Teresa left a cozy teaching job inside to do the work of God outside that God called her to do. She said, without our suffering, our work would just be social work. Very good and helpful. be the work of Jesus Christ, not part of the redemption. Jesus encouraged us to share our life with others. Mother Teresa expanded upon Jesus' parables. She adopted many metaphors that we can use to give Christ's love to others. She didn't just view the poor as those without material wealth, but those who had forgotten what love was and had no one to love them. Jesus spoke of the hungry, the homeless, and naked. Mother Teresa suggested that hunger was the want of love. Homelessness was a rejection from society as unwanted. And nakedness was not only a literal lack of clothes, but a loss of dignity. People were thirsting for love, for kindness, and compassion. Not just a physical thirst for water. Mother Teresa wrote, "Love is a one-way street. It always moves away from the self in the direction of others. Love is the ultimate gift of ourselves to others. When we stop giving, we stop loving. When we stop loving, we stop growing. And unless we grow, we will never attain personal fulfillment. We will never open out to receive the life of God. It is through love that we encounter God." Mother Teresa prayed to Jesus to deliver her from the desire to be extolled, honored, praised, preferred, consulted, approved, and popular. That's what it means to be humble. The virtues, they had no idea that they were encountering Jesus in the least of their brothers and sisters. And neither did they condemn for that matter. Humility is essential for the honorable to do God's will. Now we've talked about giving love with humility. But before we wrap up, I want to make sure you understand who to give that love to.
Come on.
In the last verse of our focal passage today, verse 40, we heard, "The king will reply, 'Truly, I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me.'" Now, we've been talking about the traditional understanding of the least of these and how Mother Teresa expands Jesus' response. But I can't leave without making sure that you understand that Jesus, in this passage, is talking about the followers of Christ. That's right. Yes, we do have an obligation to take care of the poor, the widow, the crippled, the lame, and the blind. In this passage today, the shepherd has sided with the sheep. The ones who get to wear the right robes, whose story is of ultimate salvation. Those in prison, or sick, or alien, or hungry, or naked, or thirsty. In Matthew, he uses the word least, and it's related to the word little. Now, caveat, I'm not qualified to give you a lesson on Greek, so you have to kind of take my word for it that I consulted the Greek experts on this one. But if we were taking the SAT, which has been a long time since I've done that, but the question might read something like, "Least is too little, like," or they may ask, thank you, English teachers, "as," "least is to little as, best is to good," would be the answer. "Least is to little as, best is to good." That's how they relate. So now, who are these followers that we're talking about here? They're members of the community who are in need, or who are vulnerable. That can be all of us who share the word of God with others and who proclaim it to be righteous. Now, blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness. Jesus himself identified with the needy, the marginalized, the independent, the hungry, the thirsty, the strangers, the naked, the sick, and the imprisoned. If Jesus Christ is King, the King of love, and our shepherd, as we proclaim, then we have to admit, church, that we are weak.
All right.
That means we are not self-sufficient. My sisters and brothers, we are damaged. So we probably damaged others.
All right now.
In this congregation, we're diseased. Some we call from others. Some we carry to others. We're abandoned. If we try to live out of whatever privilege we've been allowed to have, or think that we take it for ourselves, we are abandoned. Now, go back to your Bibles and you can find an example with the jailer who washed the wounds of Paul and Silas. But I want to give you an example that happened to me. And I told Georgiana I was going to mention her name today, so now she shouldn't be surprised. What she did was give me a card last month. And this was a good special card, too, because it had a little something in it.
All right, now.
But I want to read it to you. I'm like a kid. Y'all remember those days you open up the car?
Yeah.
Okay, now let me go to see what it says. Let me read it to you. Thanking God for all the beautiful things he is doing in you and through you to touch the hearts of others. Truly, your life is a reflection of his heart, and your ministry is very much appreciated. God bless you, Georgiana, October 2017. Now, for some of you, this might seem like just a card, but for me, it lifted my soul. Right then I knew it. Because sometimes some of you know you serve an environment and you don't always get little thanks when you think maybe you should, or little praise sometimes. You all work and, or have worked and know what I'm talking about. But this card, it actually made me feel appreciated. The point is that Georgiana showed me love. And she did so with humility. She didn't expect any reward, any praise, didn't know I was going to call her name out. Neither did I when she gave me that card. But here's a woman out of the good treasure of her heart, bringing forth good things. So I want each of us to understand that we are to love all human beings in need, and especially each other. As members of this Christian community, we're all sent on mission by Jesus. We all need love. So I encourage you not to overlook the followers of Jesus Christ who you encounter every day. Remember the preachers and the teachers of the word. Just think about all the hardships that Paul had. Love your neighbors. Feed, clothe, and quench the thirst of your church leaders. The persons on your job who seek peace. Your elected leaders who know Jesus, but they struggle to do what's right. My sisters and brothers, we've heard about the last teaching of Jesus before he goes to Jerusalem to face his crucifixion and death. The final judgment will accompany the second coming of Christ. are God's children, you are doing so unto Jesus Christ. The prophet Michael puts it this way: do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with your God. Or you may be familiar with this one, the seatbelt song. Do all the good you can, by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can,
at
all the times you can, to all the people you can, as long as ever you can. Now, central, the parable of the sheep and the goats, and particularly, Lord, they paying attention to the righteous, who we claim to be, warns us as we enter a new Christian year to be alert for the Son of Man's coming, and to do good at all times, to be ready for that day of judgment where we will meet Jesus face to face, hungering for our love, thirsting for our kindness, waiting to be clothed by our compassion. All those who are burdens in society, who have lost all hope in life, who have forgotten how to smile, who are no longer sensitive to the touch of love, they look to us for comfort. So if you hear that question again, what you talking about, Jesus? You'll know that Jesus wants the righteous to actively show love and humility to the least of these.
Yeah.
As Jesus called his disciples, and our reward, the following God's commands, will be an eternal life of happiness. The questions are to the sheep. Are we doing the good works that make us Christian or righteous? When it comes to central, where we're watching passers by and not even knowing.